Hello, my name is Allison Carmen, and welcome to my podcast, 10 Minutes to Less Suffering. Today, I want to talk to you about this idea, bitter or better. And I know most of you listening know exactly what this is about. There are things that happen in our lives sometimes that are hurtful, that are painful, that cause suffering. And how we show up for it often either makes us bitter or better. And I first want to say sometimes it's really hard to let go of certain things that happen to us in life. So I don't take this topic lightly. But it is true, no matter what happens to us, there comes a point in time where we often have a choice to make. And that choice will be whether whatever happened to us will keep us angry and unhappy and thinking about the past. Or possibly, there's stuff that we could learn. There's stuff that could help us move forward. So often it's things that happen in the past that create our bitterness. And these things might not have been fair. I've had people come to me with situations that I don't think are fair. I've had women come to me whose husbands have left them without warning to take care of their children by themselves. I've had business owners come to me where their partner stole from them. I've had people come to me who have been fired for reasons that were not appropriate. And many of these people have gone to court or they've tried to make agreements to try to rectify or remedy their situations. But even when people do that, there's a betrayal and there's a hurt that you could hang on to for a very long time. But the problem is, after a while, that story makes us bitter. And that story fills up our days, it fills up our nights, and there's less space for us to engage in what's going to make us better. And this reminds me of a client I had years ago who was in business with his boyfriend. And they were very close, and they were both very creative, and they had a lovely retail store in Manhattan. And I really love working with them. They just had this way about them that was so beautiful. And one day, they broke up. It was a very difficult breakup, and it spilled over into the business. And things were taken from the shop, and there were very big arguments. And for the partner that remained, things didn't quite turn out what he perceived was fair, and they never really spoke again. And he had a hard time recovering the business because there was money gone, there were some assets gone. But he used to always say that to me. He used to always say to me, bitter or better. He tried really hard to continue to let it go. And sometimes he would talk to me about his partner's problems and his pain and that he didn't really hold it against him. It was wrong and he protected himself, but bitter or better. And he's still in business today and he did eventually recover from the business breakup. I always admire how he looks at different opportunities that he has or problems that he has because he realizes that sometimes people don't act right, and sometimes things happen that you don't expect, and it doesn't mean it's fair, and it doesn't mean it's right, but the bitterness in the story can take over your life, and then your life's all about the bitterness of the story, and we don't learn our lessons, if there are lessons to learn, and we don't move forward, and we're not free to move forward. I think that's the problem, too. It's that no matter what has happened to us, if we're here, we have a life to live. And if the stories and the regrets and the bitterness don't shift somehow, they come with us. And if they come with us, we have less room to move forward. And I'm sure everyone listening to this podcast has something that's happened to them that left a bad taste in their mouth. But all we could do is look at what can be different. And I know some of my clients have said that was a very unpleasant experience, but now I'm stronger. Or that was an unpleasant experience, but now I understand my financial statements. Or that was an unpleasant experience, but now I know how to run my business better. Or if I didn't get fired, I wouldn't have pursued this new career. And the problem also is sometimes you don't have a great story to tell from what happened. But if you're here, I always believe, you know, that if there's breath, there's hope, and there's hope, there's maybe. But the bitterness holds us back. And I do have people that come to me that are telling stories from 6 years ago, 7, 8 years ago, which they can't let go of. And I never judge anybody and I don't blame anybody, but there's only so much energy we have to create a new life. And if the past owns the present, then the bitterness wins. So what can we do? How can we look through our lives of what we're hanging on to and ask bitter or better? And what you could do is that you know your regrets. You know the things you think about at night. You know the hurts that you feel towards people that you've never let go of. Write them down and see how they make you feel. And see if something about that is connecting to you today. What holds you back? And who are you holding things against? Because again, once a relationship with someone is over, whether it's business or personal, it becomes a story. And it can become a bitterness within us if we don't process what we need to process. We don't look at our part. And even if we had nothing to do with it, we could still look at ourselves. The parts maybe we didn't trust enough, the parts maybe we didn't love enough, the risks we didn't take, the things that we didn't do, whatever it is, allow yourself to look at all of it. Because bitterness takes up a lot of time and room within you, and it burns, and it makes us more irritable, and it makes us less understanding, and on some level, it closes our heart. What bitterness says is, I've done this already. I'm hurt. I'm not doing this again. I'm not going to have another relationship. I'm not going to have another business partner. Been there, done that. But every moment's new. But bitterness just tells that story and doesn't allow us to open up again. Life is not about protecting ourselves from getting hurt. Life is about opening our heart and living deep and knowing that we can trust that we'll be okay no matter what. And bitterness is against all those theories. Bitterness is what keeps us closed and keeps the story going and makes us live a life of protection and fear. Because all we want to do is avoid, tell that story and avoid it not happening again. But if we choose a life of being better, it's not that we're better, because you know that I think we're already perfect the way we are, but learning. Where's the growth here? How can I put this down and expand myself? How can I improve my situation from this experience? How can I make it better? I've had situations in my life where I have held on to bitterness for some time. And sometimes you don't even know it. You could see somebody you haven't seen for 20 years, and the minute you see them, you get all uptight and you feel your heart tense a little bit. You're like, wow, I was holding on to some bitterness with that person. You could not start a new business, like I said before, not get a new job, all because of something that happened in the past. What stories do you tell about the people in your life? What stories do you tell about your experiences? It's so much easier to look at what we can learn and to let go of the fear and let go of the worry and not be bitter and instead choose to be better. Because better includes an open heart. Better includes trusting ourselves. Better includes more time for us to get to know ourselves, to expand ourselves. But most of all, better is a life that you're not avoiding being hurt, but instead you dig deep and you say, I want to live my best life. And I'm not worried about getting hurt because I know I can handle it, but I want to live. I want to live deeply. I want to find a life of meaning. And that's where better leads you. Better leads you to a deep, meaningful life where choices that align with your heart and a life full of passion and also a life full of forgiveness. Because if we don't let go of yesterday, it comes with us. And it's like carrying a 50-pound bag on our back, and who wants that? And maybe there are things that some of us will never let go of. And maybe that's a little bit of a bitterness that we carry with us because certain things we just can't let go. But let's at least let go of what we can. Because I'd rather be better than bitter. And I bet you feel the same way about your life. So list all your situations and ask yourself, has this made me bitter or has this made me better? And if it's made you bitter, see what you could let go of. And look at the lessons and look at the wisdom and see where you can expand. But again, don't be afraid to live. Don't be afraid of pain. Because often it's not the pain that kills us. It's the decisions that we make afterwards. The choosing to hang on to our suffering, to not let things go, and to be too afraid to live our best life. You have nothing to fear and so much to gain when you open your heart and you trust yourself and you choose to be better over bitter. Thank you for listening to my podcast today. If you'd like to get in touch with me, you can email me at allison@allisoncarman.com. If you'd like to buy my book, The Gift of Maybe, it's available at all major bookstores and online retailers. And if you like this podcast, you can subscribe and leave a comment.